out, y'all. Rick's Mile in the Morning Show. Hey, man, this segment is being brought to you by Walgreens. That's right, man. Now, we all know that summer may look different this year. Walgreens is making it easier for you to find great deals with a new with their new ways to shop. This summer, shop online, in-store, or get select essentials delivered with Postmates. See Walgreens.com. That's right, Walgreens.com for details. Walgreens. All right, y'all, listen. I'm so excited to have on the show the one and only Miss Jalima Hamlett. She has information you need to know before you go back to the grocery store. Miss Jalima, good morning.
Good morning, Rickey. How are you all this morning?
We good this morning. Man, I'm just like sitting here like, what? Did I miss something? You know, because we all go to the grocery store. First of all, what is it we need to know? And thank you for coming on.
Yeah, no problem. Well, the first thing is that, you know, we're one community, one heart. Public supermarkets is, you know, a leader in retail grocery. We want the consumers to know that we're doing everything that we can to make it safe for you to come and shop, because the grocery store is in very similar proximity to going to the park, I would say, because it's open. You know, everyone comes to the grocery store, so there's no limit to what we receive in the store. We have customers.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Ricky. Well, we have customers that come to our stores that are not just coming to shop. We have customers that are coming to our store to just go to the pharmacy to get prescriptions. We have customers that are coming to our store to, you know, potentially send money to relatives, use our service, money services like Western Union or cash payroll checks and things like that. So most customers are not here just to grocery shop.
Right. So, listen, so I'm excited to have you on the show this morning. If anybody have any questions, you can call 866-9-RICKEY, 866-9-RICKEY. We just wanted to introduce you right quick. Coming back on the other side, she's going to drop some knowledge that we all need to know when you go into the grocery store. Coming up next, man, we got Jalima Hamlett up next with information that you need to know about the grocery store. Rick Smiley Morning Show. All right, y'all, Rick Smiley Morning Show. On the phone, we have Jalima Hamlett, who works as an assistant grocery store manager. We're so excited to have you on this morning. The question that I have since the pandemic, how has your store made changes to help prevent the spread of COVID-19 and flatten the curve?
Well, Rickey, we know that these are uncertain times, and we certainly want to make sure that our customers know that we're there for them. So in our stores, and if you've not visited a store lately, any of the Publix, we have installed register shields in our stores. Customer service, the pharmacy, the registers have shields. We have high traffic touch point sanitation throughout the store from open to close. We also have register lane spacing, which are markings on the floors that let you know where to stand 6 feet to observe social distancing. We also have closed our outside seating in indoor cafes and water fountains. We have one-way directional markings on our floors, arrows and X's to let you know that you should travel one way to prevent, you know, that oncoming traffic or possibility of encountering someone that is facing you. We also have foam hand sanitizer at each register for in between each register order, so that the customers are aware that we're sanitizing hands as we touch money and as we touch products. And as well for the customers as they're coming into the store, there's Puro hand sanitizer pumps at customer service for them to, you know, sanitize their hands just so that they're comfortable with coming into the locations.
So I think the question that everybody really wants to know, what's up with the Clorox and the Lysol and the Clorox wipes?
That was my question.
What's up? What's up with it?
And paper towels.
What time do y'all put the toilet paper out? What's up?
That's an excellent question, Rickey. So we're not hoarding toilet paper in the back room. We literally take from the truck once it's distributed to our stores and put it on the floor. Now, of course, the age-old saying is the early bird gets the worm. So if you're in our stores at 7 a.m. when our stores open, the likelihood of you getting toilet paper, paper towels, Clorox wipes, and Lysol wipes are good. Now, what our stores are not getting are Lysol sprays and things that are in high demand that other medical professionals are using. They don't send those items to us. But if you come into Publix, we get 3 trucks a week, and we're getting Lysol wipes, Clorox wipes, we're getting alcohol, we're getting hand sanitizer, and we're also providing masks. So we even sell masks now, which is something that we've never done previously. So you come in, you can get dial soap, our stores are completely stocked with those items by 7 a.m. every morning. And then we just recently extended our hours back out to 9 p.m. because we saw that, you know, there are first responders and medical professionals that are working late into the evening and not able to get into our stores. So then now we're open until 9 p.m. They're able to do that.
Eva, what was you talking about saying about the meat?
Well, yeah, there are all these rumors about meat shortages. You know how Tyson Factory had to kill a lot of the birds because they weren't processing them fast enough before they got old. And now you go to the store and you can't find a pack of chicken wings to save your soul. So what's going on with the meat?
Well, actually, there are going to be anticipated shortages because, you know, there are Smith Field plants and there are Tyson plants and so forth and so on that are affected by this COVID-19 pandemic. Now, at Publix, we have a multiple variety of suppliers, and we have chicken. We have ground turkey. We get fresh seafood and fresh meat weekly. Our produce and seafood come in daily, fresh. Our seafood counters are fresh with our seafood daily. We don't have a shortage of chicken. We don't have a shortage of meat of any time in Publix stores right now.
Well, I have a question. I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Brad.
My question is, how do y'all sanitize the vegetables? Because people come touch stuff. I mean, I know we do it again once we get home with all of the many things that we do it with. But how do you sanitize, like, the open vegetables? You can't, right?
They can't do nothing but spray that little water.
It's not, but if you notice in our stores, we have a mister, which is a continuous stream of water that is continually misting those fresh vegetables that are on our wet walls and so forth and so on. But, yeah, we would advise that everything that you purchase that's fresh in the grocery store, that you wash it before consuming it and, you know, cook it at an appropriate temperature. The fresh fruit that we have in the store, we also sell fruit wash, so you can certainly purchase that and, you know, wash your fruit.
Hey, Ms. Jalima, white people not buying those oxtails. Everything be gone except for the oxtails.
Let me tell you something, Ricky.
Am I lying? Am I lying, Ms. Jalima?
No, you're not lying, but let me also tell you this, that when there's a need to eat, we have seen a shift. So there's a paradigm switch right now going on with what people are eating. So I've seen some different ethnicities eating the chicken backs and the ham hocks and, you know, the smoked meat.
You better stop playing. You better get off this phone. You're going to get off this phone and stop lying.
No,
you're not going to do this today. No rich white woman came in there and bought some chicken back. I'm going to hang up right now.
Let me tell you something. You know what? Every consumer out there knows someone that has done it, whether it was the person that was their help or whether it was the person that was
Ms. Jalima? You know what, Ms. Jalima? We thought you was a true professional. We're going to hang up now. You can't come back on this show no more because you've been lying on these white people, and I don't appreciate it at all.
Miss Hawthorne
What'd you say, Gary?
Miss Hawthorne did not go in there and get no chicken backs, honey. I know that.
Said Miss Hawthorne.
No, ma'am.
Let me tell you something, Miss Hawthorne. She said Shaniqua went in to get them. I promise you.
Well, she said somebody, but Miss Hawthorne ain't going to be there, baby.
Come on, wait. Oh, my God. She said she said Shaniqua went in to get them.
She said Shaniqua, baby.
Oh, my God. Oh, my stomach hurt. I can't.
I don't even know what we're doing now. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord, help me.
Chicken bag, baby. Honey, out there
she
in the
said,
poetry department.
She said Shaniqua in there.
Yes.
Get some chicken bag. Chef, we got Kurt Bujo up next. I can't breathe. Rick's mouth. The water shot.